Please get ready for a dictation of transcription number 96 from Sir Kailash Chandra magazine. 5 seconds. Start. As you have already pointed out, under Article 323 of the Constitution, the Union Public Service Commission submits annual reports, and these reports are laid before both the Houses of Parliament, along with any memorandum, if there be any, from the government explaining their position as to why they have not accepted the particular advice of the Commission. Sir, we have so far received 3 such reports from the Commission, and I have gone through these reports. Sir, the general impression that I have gathered after going through these 3 reports is that, apart from the fact that there have been cases of non-acceptance of the Commission's advice in many important matters, there are, sir, very serious irregularities committed by the executive government in the matter of appointments to the civil posts and the civil services. If you permit me, sir, I may add that I have found that there are occasions when the government has even bypassed the Houses of Parliament in their anxiety to provide for their favorites. Sir, under Article 320 of the Constitution, as you have already pointed out, the recruitments to civil posts and the civil services are to be made by the Union Public Service Commission. There are 2 basic ideas underlying this system of recruitment to the civil services adopted in our Constitution. Firstly, we desire that all eligible persons to a particular post should be entitled to enter into a fair and free competition to get that job. Secondly, we want to avoid all elements of patronage in the matter of appointments to our civil services. You will find that under the old regulation, which has been kept in force under Article 372, there are several categories of employment and posts which have been kept away from the purview of the Union Public Service Commission. One of these categories is temporary appointments lasting for less than a year. I maintain from a review of all these reports that the government has abused this power of temporary appointments. The government has used it as a shield to bestow all kinds of patronage. Sir, if you look at the posts, you will find that on the very face of it, they are not temporary posts, but that they are likely to continue for more than a year. Sir, appointments to such posts are made as temporary appointments merely to avoid the Union Public Service Commission. In the name of temporary and emergency appointments, I find that a large number of appointments are being made. The glaring examples are the Community Projects Administration and the All India Radio under the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. We find, as a matter of fact, such appointments being made by every ministry, but these are the very glaring examples, and I would like the Honorable Minister to tell this House as to how many temporary appointments are being made every year by the government and how many of them are continued even after the end of the year. Sir, they make the temporary appointments and they keep these appointments going on year after year, and they do not also consult the commission, although under the constitution they are required to do so. Apart from bringing in an element of patronage in the civil appointments, this procedure acts very unfairly to the other candidates who compete from the open market when these temporary posts are made permanent. When the appointments are regularized by inviting applications by means of advertisements, what happens is this: we cannot prevent these temporary appointees from competing in such examinations, and these temporary appointees who have gained experience at the cost of the taxpayer compete with the candidates from the open market and do better because of the experience that they have gained. I know it from my personal knowledge that appointments in the temporary cadre are purposely made in order that a particular candidate may gain experience and do better at competitive examinations and have a better chance of getting a permanent government service. Otherwise, he could never have got such a post. Sir, not only this, but the commission have also referred to the fact that advertisements are drafted in such a way that it may suit a particular person. On page 9 of the first report, they say advertisements for posts in the category of technical, scientific or specialized qualifications are often so drafted by ministries as to tend to restrict the recruitment to the limited circle of persons already holding the posts advertised or analogous posts. One of the main functions of the commission is to so draft the advertisement without sacrificing the requirements of the post as to ensure a competitive selection for the post from the widest field. Stop.